Good morning, students. Welcome to Commodore Group of Schools online classes. So, in last previous class, we have learned what is polynomial and the types of polynomials. After that, how to find the zeros of the polynomial by using Rafsals. Now, we are going to discuss the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients of a polynomial. So, already we learned what is the zeros. Zeros are nothing but they are the values of x, or this satisfies the polynomial. So, they are values of x. Values of the variables will satisfy the polynomial. Now, here we have to know what the coefficients. So, what are coefficients? Coefficients are nothing but they are the multiples of the variables. So, multiples of a variable. For example, if you take 2x. Now, x is a variable and its multiple is 2. So, this 2 we call it as the coefficient. For example, like another example. So, 3xy. So, in this, xy is the variables and 3 is the multiple of that variable. So, this 3 we call them as the coefficient of xy. So, coefficients are nothing but they are the multiples of the variable. For example, if you take the general form of quadratic polynomial, that is ax square plus bx plus c, where a is not equal to 0. Then, in this quadratic polynomial, the coefficients are a, b and c. So, all they are the multiples of the coefficients. So, coefficients are a, b, c. So, that is coefficients. Now, we are going to learn the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients. So, if you take some example, let it be p of x is equal to x square minus 5x plus 6. So, if you take this example, in this, first we will find the zeros of this polynomial and after we will find the relation between coefficients and zeros. So, if you find the zeros, if you want to find the zeros, we have different methods. So, in that, one of the method is by splitting the middle term. So, by splitting the middle term, if you find it, so the process is first term and last term, we have to multiply. So, if you multiply these two, what will get? 6 into x square, 6x square. Then, after that, we have to divide the 6x square into two parts. And if you add these two parts, we have to get the middle term. And if you multiply these two parts, we have to get the above term. So, for example, if I take minus 2x and minus 3x here. So, if these two terms, if I add, so minus 2, minus 3, we get minus 5x. And if you multiply these two, minus into minus plus, 2, 3 is 6, x into x, x square. So, like that we have to take. Now, in place of minus 5x, we can write minus 2x and minus 3x. So, we can write this as x square minus 2x minus 3x plus 6. Now, we are having four terms. In these four terms, if you take two terms, in these two terms, x is common. So, if you take x as common, then x minus 2 will get. Then, similarly, in these two terms, minus 3 is common. If you take minus 3 as common, then we will get again x minus 2. Now, in these two terms, here two terms are there. In these two terms, again x minus 2 is common. So if you take x minus 2 as common, then the remaining is x minus 3. Now we got the factors. Now if we equate these factors to 0, then we'll get zeros of the polynomial. So x minus 2 is equal to 0. Another one is x minus 3 is equal to 0. So then what do you get? X is equal to 2. Here x is equal to 3. Now they are the zeros of this polynomial. Zeros of this object of the given polynomial. Now, this is one zero, this is another zero. Now, if I add these two zeros, then what do you get? So, sum of zeros. So, if I add these two zeros, so let it be this is one zero and this is another zero. If we add that, then what do you get? 2 plus 3. This is one zero, this is another zero. So, 2 plus 3, which is nothing but, we'll get 5. 5 we can write it as 5 by 1 also. Then again, For our convenience, we can write my 5 as minus of minus 5. Minus of minus 5. Because if you multiply it, minus into minus, again we'll get plus. So this one only will get. So our convenience, we are writing 5 as minus of minus 5. Now, if you observe minus, here minus 5 is there. If you observe the given polynomial, this minus 5 is nothing but it is the coefficient of x. It is the coefficient of x. So in place of minus 5, we can write it is the coefficient of x. Coefficient of x. Similarly, if you see the denominator, 1 is there. And again, if you compare with the general, with the given polynomial, here 1 is nothing but it is the coefficient of x square. So here denominator we can write it as coefficient of x square. So if we add the zeros, what you are getting? So which is equal to minus of coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. So this is the relation between zeros and then the coefficients of the given polynomial. Similarly, if you multiply or if you take the product of these two zeros, then what do you get? So product of zeros. Product of zeros. If you multiply it, again we'll get 1 0 is 2, another 0 is 3. So 2 into 3, we'll get 6. Again 6, we can write it as 6 by 1. 6 by 1. Again, if you compare with the given polynomial, 6 is nothing but it is a constant term here. So 6 is the constant term. So we can write it as constant term. And also 1. 1 is nothing but it is the coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square. Now here also, it is the relation between zeros and the coefficients here. If you take the product of zeros, what you are getting? Constant term by coefficient of x square. So that is the relation between zeros and coefficients. Now, we will generalize this process to the general form of a polynomial. So if you take the general form of a polynomial, p of x is equal to ax square plus bx plus c, where a is not equal to 0. You know that it is a general form of the quadratic polynomial. Now, if you generalize this given, we did the example. So if you compare with this general form, then how will you get? Now, just now we saw that if it is a polynomial as x square minus 5x plus 6, and if you find the factors, then we got x square minus 2x minus 3x plus 6. Similarly, if you take the common, then x minus 2 here, if you take minus 3 as common, then again we are getting x minus 2. Again, if you take x minus 2 as common, we are getting x minus 3. Now, they are the factors, and if we equate it to 0, we are getting the 0. So x minus 2 is equal to 0. Another one is x minus 3 is equal to 0. That is x is equal to 3 and x is equal to 2. Now see here, if it is a polynomial, here also we have taken x square minus 5x plus 6. So how we are getting the polynomial? So if you know the zeros, then if we first we have to write its factors, and if we multiply, then we are getting the polynomial. So for this polynomial, we don't know the zeros. So if you assume the two factors as alpha and beta, so let alpha and beta are the zeros of P of X. So alpha and beta, they are the Greek alphabets. So let alpha and beta are the zeros of this polynomial. So here in this example we got 2 and 3. Now here we are taking that zeros as alpha and beta. So to get this polynomial, so we have to take the factors. So how will we get the factors? If it is x is equal to 2, we are taking the factor as x minus 2. If it is 3, we are getting the factor as x minus 3. So here if it is plus 2, we are getting minus 2. Similarly here plus is there, again we are getting minus. For example, if x value is minus 2, then the factor is x plus 2. So opposite sign we will get. If the zero is minus 3, then we will get the factor as plus 3. So we will get the opposite sign. Now we have taken alpha and beta as the zeros of the polynomial. So we will get the factors as So what will get the factors? Both are plus only. So x minus alpha, x minus beta. So they are the factors of the given zeros. For these zeros, these two are the factors. Now we know that if you multiply these two factors, then we'll get the polynomial. So in this x minus 2, x minus 3 is there. So for example, if I take another constant like this one, so we can write it 1 into x minus 2 into x minus 3. So this is a factor, this one is a factor, and this is constant. So if you multiply this 3, then you'll get the polynomial. Similarly, so here x minus alpha and x minus beta is there. So to get this polynomial, to get ax square plus bx plus c, we can write it as x minus alpha into x minus beta. If you multiply these two factors, then only you'll get this polynomial. So we are producting it. And also here, 1 is there. 1 is nothing but constant. So we can take some constant also here. So k into x minus alpha into x minus beta, where k is constant. And if you multiply these two, then you'll get this polynomial. So if you multiply it. So k into. So if you multiply x into x, x square, x into beta, x beta. Similarly, if we multiply the second term, minus alpha into x, minus x alpha, and then minus into minus plus, alpha into beta, alpha beta. Again, in this, k into x square minus, in this two, if you take x as common, then what will get? Alpha plus beta. If you take x as common, then we'll get alpha plus beta, and the constant remaining, the remaining term is alpha beta. Now multiply with k, then what will get? So k into x square minus, so k into x alpha plus beta, so in last term k into alpha beta. So now if you observe, ax square plus bx plus c, here we are having kx square minus kx into alpha plus beta plus k alpha beta. Now if you compare these two polynomials, so x square coefficient is a, here x square coefficient is k. So we can write it as a is equal to k by comparing both the polynomials. Similarly, here, so x term is b, here x term is k minus k into alpha plus beta. So x term, if you compare, then you will get b is equal to, so in this b is equal to here, minus k into alpha plus beta. Similarly, constant term, so constant term c is equal to, here the constant term is k into alpha beta. C is equal to k into alpha beta. Now again, we got a is equal to k. Now if you take this one, and if you write this k to the left side, then minus b by k is equal to alpha plus beta. Similarly here also, if you write k to the left side, it becomes division. So c by k is equal to alpha beta. Just now we have learned that alpha and beta are the zeros of the polynomial. So what we got here, alpha plus beta is nothing but, it is the sum of the zeros. So alpha and beta are the zeros. What we are doing here, we are adding it. If you add it, then what you get here? Minus b by k. Where k is nothing but, which is equal to a. So if you substitute in place of k as minus b by a, because a is equal to k. So in place of k we are writing a. So which is nothing but, which is equal to minus of b. B is nothing but, it is a coefficient of x. So b is coefficient of x. Similarly, a is nothing but, it is a coefficient of x square. So sum of zeros. So which is equal to minus b by a, minus of coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. Similarly, if you take the third equation, c by k is equal to alpha beta we got. So c by k, alpha beta is nothing but alpha into beta is nothing but product of zeros. product of zero. So this product of zeros, what we got? C by K. C by K. So C by K is nothing but you can take it as A. C by A, which is equal to, again if we compare with the general form, so here C is nothing but it is a constant term. Constant term. And then A is nothing but coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square. So what we can conclude is, if alpha and beta are the zeros of the quadratic polynomial ax square plus bx plus c, then the sum of zeros. So if you take alpha and beta, then its sum of zeros means alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, which is equal to minus of coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. Similarly, product of zeros are nothing but alpha into beta, that is c by a, which is equal to constant term by coefficient of x square. Polynomial. For example, p of x is equal to 3x square plus 5x minus 2. 3x square plus 5x minus 2. So if you take this polynomial and we know how to find the zeros of that polynomial. So how will you get the zeros? So in this, 3x square, so first time and last time we have to multiply, then you'll get minus 6x square. So we have to split it into two parts. So what will get here? So if I take 6x and minus 1x, so 6x minus 1x will get 5x, and similarly if you multiply minus 6x square you will get, so we can write in place of 5x as plus 6x minus 1x minus 2. Similarly in these two terms, if you take 3x as common, then what will get? x plus 2. Similarly, in this two, if I take minus 1 as common, then again we'll get x plus 2. In these two terms again, x plus 2 is common. So if you take x plus 2 as common, then you'll get 3x minus 1. So if we equate it to 0, we'll get the zeros of the polynomial. That is x is equal to minus 2. Here, 3x is equal to 1, x is equal to 1 by 3. Now we got the zeros of this polynomial. Now, up to now we learned how to find the zeros of the polynomial if you know the polynomial by using different methods. One is splitting the middle term, otherwise another method is by using graphs also we know how to find the zeros if you know the polynomial. For example, if you know the polynomial, if you know the zeros, then if you want to find the polynomial, if you know the polynomial, we can find the zeros. But if we know the zero, then how to find the quadratic polynomial? So I will get that. So if you take that, first we have to take the two zeros. So let the two zeros be alpha and beta. Are the zeros of P of X. So for some polynomial, we are taking alpha and beta are the zeros. If they are the zeros, just now we learned, if you know the zeros, to get the polynomial, we have to write its factors. So, x is equal to 2. So, we'll get x plus 2 as a factor. If it is minus 2, we are getting plus. If it is plus, we will get minus. So, for alpha and beta, the factors are, so what will get the factors? The factors are x minus alpha into x minus beta. So, they are the factors. And with that, we can take some real number also, so that is some constant. So if I take k into x minus alpha into x minus beta, if you multiply these two, then you will get the polynomial. Now multiply it. So k into, if you multiply, then what you get? X into x, x square, x into beta, x beta. Then similarly, if you multiply this one, x alpha minus into minus plus, alpha into beta, will get alpha beta. Now again, so k into x square minus x into, if I take alpha, x as common, then we will get alpha plus alpha beta. Now, we can observe that if you know the zeros, then we are getting the quadratic polynomial. So, if alpha and beta are the zeros of the polynomial, then the polynomial we will get is k into x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta. So, what we can conclude is, If you know the zeros and if you want to find the quadratic polynomial, then this is the quadratic polynomial. So in this, if you substitute alpha plus beta and alpha beta, then we'll get the zeros. For example, in this example only, if you see, so here we got x is equal to minus 2 and x is equal to 1 by 3. Now if you substitute this polynomial, then we have to get the above polynomial. If you substitute these zeros, then we will have to get the above polynomial. What is the polynomial? 3x square plus 5x minus 2. So we have to get this polynomial if you substitute these values in this given polynomial. So here x is equal to minus 2 and x is equal to 1 by 3. So let us assume that here 1 0 is alpha, another 0 is beta. 1 is alpha, we are taking, another value is beta. Now here if you want to substitute in this, we have to know alpha plus beta and alpha beta. So first find alpha plus beta and alpha beta. So alpha plus beta is equal to, so here alpha is nothing but minus 2 plus and beta is 1 by 3. Beta is 1 by 3. Now in this, if you take LCM, LCM is 3. So here what do you get? Minus 6 plus 1. So minus 6 plus 1, which is minus 5 by 3. Minus 5 by 3. So alpha plus beta is minus 5 by 3. Similarly, if you find alpha beta, product of zeros. So minus 2 into 1 by 3. So what do you get? Minus 2 by 3. So that is the product of zeros. And if you know the zeros, if you know the alpha and beta values, then to find the quadratic polynomial, we are having the polynomial as k into x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta. Now take this one. So k into x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta. Now k into x square minus x into alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta we got minus 5 by 3. Minus 5 by 3 plus alpha beta. Alpha beta is nothing but minus 2 by 3. Minus 2 by 3. Now again, if you multiply, then k into x square minus into minus plus, so plus 5x by 3. Similarly, plus into minus is minus, minus 2 by 3. Now for this 3 term, if you take LCM, so k into LCM is 3, then what will you get if you multiply each term with this LCM? So 3 into x square, 3x square, and if you multiply these two, 3, 3 gets cancelled. So plus 5x minus 2 by 3 into 3, again 3, 3 gets cancelled, so you will get minus 2. So 3x square plus 5x minus 2. Now here, denominator is 3 is there. So in place of k, we can substitute any value. For example, if I take the k as 3, if you substitute in place of k as 3, then what do you get here? 3, 3 gets cancelled. So you will get the remaining polynomial as 3x square plus 5x minus 2. So you will get this polynomial. So what we can conclude is, if you know the zeros, alpha and beta, then to get the polynomial, we have to take k into x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta. So here also, if you observe, if you have taken alpha is equal to minus 2 and beta is equal to 1 by 3, then if you substitute in this formula, then what we are getting? We are getting the polynomial. So up until now we learned that if the quadratic polynomial is ax square plus bx plus c, where a is not equal to 0, then if alpha comma beta are the zeros, then sum of zeros alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, which is equal to minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. Similarly, product of zeros. Product of zeros, alpha into beta is equal to C by A, which is equal to, C is nothing but constant R. So, constant R by coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square. Product of zeros alpha into beta is equal to C by A, which is nothing but constant term by coefficient of x square. So this we have learned. And also with this, if you know the zeros and the polynomials, if you know the zeros, then how to get the polynomial? That is, if alpha and beta are the zeros, if alpha and beta are the zeros, then the quadratic polynomial, then the quadratic polynomial is k into x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta. So up to now we learn this one. So sum of zeros alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, and product of zeros alpha beta is equal to c by a. So this is the relation between sum of, that is, zeros and the coefficients. Zeros and the coefficients. And here also the relation between zeros and the coefficients there. And similarly, if you know the zeros and if you want to find the quadratic polynomial, then this is the formula, that is k into x square minus x into alpha plus alpha beta. Now we'll see some examples. Find the zeros of x square plus 7x plus 10, x square plus 7x plus 10, and verify the relationship between, zeros and the coefficient. Zeros and the coefficients. Now, they have given polynomial, we have to find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial, and also we have to find the relationship between zeros and coefficients. So, first find the zeros of the given polynomial. So, given p of x is equal to x square plus 7x plus 10. So, to find the zeros, we can use the splitting method. So that is, we can fit the middle term. So I will get that. So first term and last term we have to multiply. Then we will get 10x square. And we have to divide it into two parts. So we can take here 5x and 2x. So if you add it 5 and 2, we will get 7. And if you multiply it, we will get 10x square. So these two terms satisfies. So we can take here x square plus, in place of 7x, we can write 5x plus 2x plus 10. Just we are splitting it. Then after that, in these four terms, so in these two terms, if we take x as common, then we'll get x plus 5. So in these two terms, if we take 2 as common, again we'll get x plus 5. Now again in these two terms, x plus 5 is common. So if we take x plus 5 as common, then the remaining is x plus 2. Now we got the factors, and if we equate these factors to 0, then we will get x values. So which is equal to, that is, if we equate it to 0, x plus 5 is equal to 0. Similarly, x plus 2 is equal to 0. That is, x is equal to minus 5 and x is equal to minus 2. Now we got the zeros. So first they asked you to find the zeros, we got the zeros. Then after that, we have to find the relation between zeros and coefficients, which is nothing but we have to find the sum of zeros and product of zeros. So, first one, sum of zeros, that is, which is equal to, so add this to zeros, what do you get? Minus 5, minus 2, which is equal to minus 7. So, minus 7 we can write it as minus 7 by 1, which is equal to, again we can write minus, this 7 is nothing but, if you compare with the given polynomial, This 7 is nothing but coefficient of x. So coefficient of x by, and 1 is nothing but it is the coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square. Similarly, we have to find the product of zeros. Product of zeros. So product means you have to multiply this to this, two zeros. So minus 5 into minus 2. Minus into minus plus 5 to that 10. So again we can write 10 as 10 by 1. Then if you compare with the given problem here, this 10 is nothing but which is a constant term, and then constant term, and then 1 is nothing but coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square. So that is the relation between zeros and the coefficient. So zeros minus 5 minus 2, and it's if you compare with the given polynomial, then you'll get minus of coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. So they are the relation between zeros and the coefficients. Solutions.